Now, 9th CBSE chapter 6, you are seeing this exercise 6.2, 5th sum. See, in the figure, AB is parallel to CD, angle APQ is 50 degree and angle PRD is equal to 127. And then you are supposed to find out angle X and Y. Let's see how to find out this. Now, these are the things given to you. AB parallel to CD, angle APQ is 50, angle PRD is 127. You are supposed to find out X and Y. See, AB, first one, AB is parallel to CD, isn't it? Consider this, AB and parallel to CD, and PQ will be the, PQ is the transversal, this side, PQ is the transversal. AB and CD are parallel, PQ is a transversal in which angle APQ and angle PQ are, angle APQ and angle PQR are alternate interior angles which are equal. Angle APQ is equal to angle PQR, reason alternate interior angles. Alternate interior angles, okay. But angle APQ is given as 50, angle PQR is given as X. So this implies X is equal to 50 degree. So we found X, okay. Next we are supposed to find out Y. Before finding Y, just see PQR is a triangle. It's a triangle. We got one angle. You have to find out Y. For that, you need one more, the third angle of the triangle. See, angle PRD is given as 127. For what purpose they have given angle PRD? That is, angle PRD is kuduthirukanga. Angle PRD and the third angle PRQ are this angle. This angle and this angle are linear pairs. These two angles are linear pairs. So, you can find out angle, see, angle PRD and angle PRQ are linear pairs. Angle on a straight line, isn't it? Are linear pairs. So, angle PRQ is equal to, or this plus angle PRD equal to 180 degree. So, angle PRQ is therefore, this is given as 127, isn't it? So, this is 180. So, angle PRQ is therefore equal to 180 minus 127. That is 10 minus 7 is 3. 7 minus 2 is 5. 53 degree. See, 7 plus 3, 10. Remainder 1, 6 plus 2, 8. So, angle PRQ, we found this as 53 degree. So, in triangle, PQR, you know, angle, the sum of the angles in a triangle is equal to 180 degree. So, one angle is X plus Y plus angle PRQ is equal to 180 degree. This X is, here you found that as 50. 50 plus Y plus angle PRQ, you found that as 53 equal to 180. 50 plus 53 is 103. Plus Y is equal to 180. This implies Y equal to 180 minus 103. That is, Y is equal to 10 minus 3 is 7. 7 minus 0 is 7. So, hence we found Y as 77 degree. That's all. Understood this? See, AB is given as parallel to CD. And the angle APQ is given as 50. Then angle PRD is given as 127. This X and Y are unknown. So how we are proving? Since AB and CD are parallel, AP and CQ will also be a parallel line in which PQ is a transversal. So APQ and PQR, this X, APQ 50 and X are, what type of angles are they? Those two angles are, what type of angles are they? Alternate interior angles. So, if the as they are parallel, alternate interior angles are equal. So, X is equal to 50 degree. Now, coming to this side, PB is parallel to RB. So, In that case, you have to find out this. If you know this angle, you can find out this. That's not our problem. It's given angle PRD is equal to 127. Now, PQR is a triangle. We know this angle. We are supposed to find out this and we have to find out this. So, how to find out this? Angle PRQ and angle PRB are linear pairs. That is, sum of the angles equal to 180 degree, and from that angle PRQ equal to 180 minus 127 is 53 degree. So we found this angle and this angle as x as 50, x as 50, and this angle as 53, and you have to find out this. How to find out this? And in triangle PQR, sum of the three angles is 180. So, 50 degree plus 5 plus 53 equal to 180. From that, y equal to 180 minus 103, which gives you 77 degree. Hence, the third angle of the triangle PQR is 77. Can you understand this? Yes, you can understand. We'll see, I think we have finished. We'll see the next sum in the next class. Okay, thank you.